Thank you for joining this presentation. My name is Martijn Starmans. I'm a PhD student at the Erasmus Medical Center, Rotterdam, Netherlands. And I will tell you a bit today about multicentric studies for more robust radiomic signatures. So I have no conflicts of interest to disclose. So in this session, we've already talked a lot about radiomics. So let me quickly recap what it's all about. So in radiomics, we start with some radiographic medical images. On those, we use radiomics, in which we extract quantitative features from these medical images. And we use some form of data mining, for example, artificial intelligence methods, in order to find a pattern within these features. And that produces a so-called biomarker. So something we might use in clinical practice to make predictions on these images. So if you want to know more about radiomics, I would highly advise you to read this book chapter we wrote a while ago, which you can see here in the right corner. So we've seen that radiomics is quite a generic concept. So that may also explain why it has gained a lot of attention in the last years. So we see that there have been many studies on radiomics. So for example, last year at ECR alone, we saw that there are almost 400 abstracts mentioning radiomics. And you see that these are on a wide variety of applications. So for example, in coronary plaque, in liver cancer, prostate cancer, brain cancer, and that has spawned a wide variety of methods of implementations, so mostly software implementations, and also many different data sets. So that sort of arises a problem, because now there are so many methods to choose from, it's very difficult to pick which one would suit you. So suppose you want to start using radiomics, which of all the methods available will you use? So it's very difficult to compare these methods and also to combine these methods, because you might have to use parts of different methods to find the best approach. So finding the best method for your specific clinical problem can be quite a tedious procedure. And also there's no guarantee that in the process of doing so, you find the best method for your application. So that's why the goal of this talk is to see if we can find one method that works for all applications. So therefore, we have created a couple of learning objectives, which are also the outline for this talk. So first of all, I will introduce a framework for the rapid development of radiomic signatures. Second, we will explain how the parameters of such a radiomics pipeline can be automatically optimized, and I will demonstrate its use on a variety of different applications. So before we do that, let's maybe first talk about this signature thing that arises in our first goal. What is exactly a radiomic signature? So as I started out in radiomics, we look at radiological images. So for example, here I have CT scans of the liver, and usually we have a segmentation of a region of interest. And where we want to go is to a prediction model. So for example, here we distinguish between replacement and desmoplastic growth patterns. So how do we do so? And therefore, what is a signature? Well, a signature is a way to go from these images and segmentations using quantitative image features, so features that describe something about our region of interest. And we use these extracted features in a specific combination. And that combination is usually learned by AI, for example. And that basically compiles the signature that we have. So that also gives two questions when creating a signature. What kind of features do you use? And what kind of data mining methods do you use? So let's start out with the first point. Which features do you use? Well, if you look around in the literature, you can see that there's a wide variety of radiomics features and also radiomics toolboxes to use. So toolboxes to extract these features. So for example, here I've listed six toolboxes, which are used in many different studies. And you see that these have been developed over the last couple of years. So while all these toolboxes share some features, they each also have unique features. And also in each of them, specific designer choices might have been made in how to extract specific features. So you would have to pick which of these toolboxes you want to use and which features you want to extract. So suppose you pick a toolbox, then we arrive at which data mining methods to use. And I rather use data mining than AI, because usually this is not a single method that you use, but rather a pipeline or a workflow of methods. So methods which you may use in this data mining workflow are, for example, feature selection methods, in which from all the features you extracted, you only select relevant features for your application. Resampling methods, so if there's an imbalance in your data set, for example, you have more malignant than benign tumors, You might resample in order to get a more balanced data set, which might help your AI algorithm. And you can also use, for example, feature imputation methods. When values are missing for specific patients, these methods guess what the value would have been. And there are many more approaches that you can use. And usually people end with a classifier, so machine learning method, which uses the processed features to combine them into a decision rule. So there are many different components you can use here. And in each component, for example, in feature selection, there are a lot of methods that you can use. And another important note to make is that most of these methods also have parameters which you can choose. So what do we end up with? Well, we end up with having to pick features and AI methods to use in our radiomic signature. So which methods do we pick? So that's quite complicated. So let's go through this step by step. So what we did, we first split up this radiomics workflow into a modular workflow. So we've defined specific components in a radiomics workflow, for example, feature extraction, feature selection, etc. Then what we've done is we've standardized all these components. So they occur in a specific order and each of them gets a specific label. So like I said, feature extraction, feature selection, etc. And then since we've standardized these components, we can go ahead and include many different methods for each of these components. So what we end up with is basically our first objective or learning goal, a framework for rapid development of signatures. Because now we have a framework in which we have a standardized workflow and in which we can include many different radiomics methods actually. But now how can we use this for the rapid development? Because there are still many different solutions in this platform. So how can we rapidly get a working signature out of all these methods? Well, that's basically where our second learning goal comes in, because in order to do something rapidly, a good choice is often to automate this process. So what we're going to do is to automate both the method selection, so which methods to use, and also the parameter optimization. So basically we want to automatically optimize everything. And that sort of combines our two learning goals. So this might go a little bit quick, so let's zoom out a little bit. So what is the concept that we're going at? So what we're currently looking at, what we see around, is that suppose we start on a new radiomic study. So here on the left, we start with a study on liposarcoma. And on these patients, we might want to predict something about their genetics. So we're going to use a specific radiomics platform for that. So suppose I now hire one of you with limited experience in radiomics. You start looking around what's available in the literature, and you end up with a couple of methods that you combine into a pipeline or workflow. So you pick a feature extraction toolbox, you pick a feature selection toolbox, you tune the parameters a bit, and you might end up with a working solution. So suppose I would hire a second person on a different study. They might repeat this process, but probably they will do this a little bit differently and end up at this orange pipeline, which is a bit different, which might work for the second application, but you wonder which one in the end will work best. And in another study, this will happen again, etc., etc. So here the concept that we're aiming at, what we're doing here, is to kind of breach these barriers. So we're not looking anymore at one study at a time, but we're more looking at a generic concept, something which will work on many different studies. And all these studies go into the same radiomics platform. No pipeline per platform anymore. So what our platform should now do, so like I already said, we have a platform with a modular workflow. So for all these modules, we have different components, so different feature extraction methods, different feature selection methods, etc. And our pipeline or platform should now automatically find the right pathway between all these methods in order to find the best combination for each application. And thereby for each application, you will end up with a specific workflow which will work best for that application. So what we basically do in that way is we reduce developing a radiomic signature to basically this box with a red button where we just input a new imaging data set, press the red button, and the platform automatically finds a good working radiomics workflow. So how do we do this? How does our platform actually automate this optimization? So what we currently do is we start out with all the features because repeatedly computing features is a bit redundant. And what we then do is we just start spawning random workflows. So a workflow consists of a specific combination of methods and parameters. Then we simply execute all these workflows and we can rank them according to their performance. So for example, their accuracy. Then what we could do is pick the best performing workflow, but we've seen that for stability, is best to average the top performing workflows. So for example, average the best 50 workflows. And that will give us one final radiomic signature. So this this summarizes our platform that we propose, the workflow for optimal radiomics classification or work, where we can just automatically, per application, develop a radiomic signature. So that ends up already with our third learning goal. We've made this platform, which we can use for automatic development of radiomic signatures, and I will now demonstrate its performance on a couple of applications. So let's just start out with one application or one experiment. So in this application, we're looking at lipoma and liposarcoma, two different types of tumors. So for these tumors, we have imaging and we have T1 and T2 weighted MRI. And what we want to predict here is the so-called MDM2 amplification, because that distinguishes between these two tumors. And we have a data set here of 116 patients. And what's good to note is that this data set actually originates from 41 different scanners. So this is a multi-center data set. And for this talk, I actually have another talk in this ECR. So if you're interested, please look at that specific presentation. So besides this one experiment, I will actually demonstrate you the use of work on four other applications. I will not go into detail, but you can see it's a wide variety of clinical applications. We have different modalities. So we have CT and MRI, and within MRI, different types of sequences. We have different types of things we want to predict. We have data sets varying from pretty small, 76 patients, to a bit larger, so over 200 patients. And most of these are very heterogeneous because they're multicentric. For all of these, I have another talk. So if you're interested, please go to these specific sessions. So I want to stretch that for all these experiments, we use the exact same settings per experiment. We only change the input data. So this middle platform stays the same. So if we input liver CT, we use the platform, we get a specific signature. If we go to different application, we only change the input data and get, of course, a different model, et cetera, et cetera. We use exactly the same settings. So let me show you some results. So it's good to report that for all these results, I've actually done a cross-validation. So I split the data in a training and a testing part. On the training, we do all model optimization and training. And testing, we only do the evaluation on the testing set. We only use it for actual testing. So there are a lot of numbers here, but I want to focus on the AUC, the area under the curve, which is highlighted in blue, because this is a nice balanced metric. And you can see that the performance for all the applications is well above 0.5, so well above guessing. So automatically, our work platform has found a working radiomic signature in each of these different applications. Well, we've used exactly the same settings in all applications. So that brings me to my conclusion, and thereby also finalizing the learning goals. So I've introduced you a framework which we can use for rapid development of radiomic signatures. We do so by automating the process of finding a good solution within a huge landscape of different methods and parameters. And I've shown you that it works on a variety of different applications. So what's good to note about this platform is that it's open source, so it's free to use. So like I said, it's also very easy to use because it automates the whole process. You only need a couple of lines of code, and I hope I've convinced you that it works in a wide variety of applications. So I have a couple of talks of ECR this year and previous year where we've actually used work to demonstrate you how it works. So if you're interested, please go to this site that's mentioned below or contact me and just try it out yourself. So these are my ethics, approval, and funding. And thank you very much for watching. I hope you've enjoyed my talk and want to give the work platform a try.